I'm not just going to put them in like S tier, A tier, B tier, because if that was the case, they would all be in F tier. Hi, welcome back to me talking about whatever I want. Today I want to talk about how terrible these Super Bowl commercials were. The 2020 Super Bowl gave me mixed feelings. I enjoyed the halftime performance, I thought the commercials were atrocious, and I don't know how football works, so I don't really care who won. For me, the highlights of watching the Super Bowl has always been watching the advertisements, because it's the time of year when advertisers put in their biggest budgets, their best plans, and their greatest commercials. And that's why I'm saddened to find out that they've just been getting worse and worse every single year. But before I dive into those, of course, I'd like to do a comment shout out from last video. Theory: D'Angelo is a secret government spy. Well, unbearable human. If that's the case, this channel has been doing so well that 64,000 people now know my secret identity. So suffice it to say, I'm the worst secret government spy to ever exist. All jokes aside though, the channel is doing super well. I'm always appreciative. I actually love doing these daily uploads, and I guess I'm just more surprised that you keep coming back and watching them. But hey, if you're here, I'm here. And unfortunately, so are these terrible Super Bowl ads. So my brilliant idea is to create a tier list where I rank every single Super Bowl ad, or at least all the ones I could get my hands on. Now, some commercials ran more than one advertisement, so I'm just going to pick one from each. But the thing is, I'm not just going to put them in like S tier, A tier, B tier, because if that was the case, they would all be in F tier. They were just all bad, okay? All of them. Instead, I've designed my own tier list. So as you can see, we have C, D, E, F. There's no A or B because none of them are that good. But these are not just letter grades. I discovered upon rewatching the ads that they all fit into four categories: cinematic, dancing, emotional, or famous people. So the cinematic ones are just like movie parodies or commercials where they try to make it look like a really high budget thing when it's just a commercial. The dancing commercials are pretty self-explanatory. For some reason, there's a lot of dancing during these Super Bowl ads. The emotional commercials are my personal least favorite. Basically, these ads are taking a bunch of emotional music and emotional topics and manipulating you into feeling a certain way. And then once you're in your feelings, it's a car ad. And then the famous people section are the ones that are just not interesting, funny, or remotely entertaining, but they have famous people in them, so I guess I'm watching them anyway. The fact that I'm gonna pretty easily be able to fit all of these advertisements into just four categories really speaks to the fact that advertisers have basically given up. There is so little originality, humor, charm, life, dare I say, in these Super Bowl commercials, but if I had to sit through them, so did you.
People tell me that people aren't ready to have a woman lead, but these guys have been learning from women their whole lives.
So here we have a dramatic ad about women's empowerment. So go ahead and take a wild guess about what this ad is for. Microsoft. It's a computer advertisement. So this is easily going in emotional, because what does this have to do with computers?
Kick back and be totally comfortable in my own skin. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so that was a horrifying advertisement from Rocket Mortgage, in which we find Jason Momoa shedding his muscles. That definitely goes under famous people, but now that I'm looking at this, I realize I should have added another category for nightmare fuel, because what on earth? My therapist: skinny Jason Momoa can't hurt you. Skinny Jason Momoa.
We need backup. That's not what I meant!
Okay, so this largely incoherent Procter & Gamble ad just had a bunch of celebrities in it. This is a real example of how people just give up once they finally get the celebrities to sign the contract. They're like, phew, we don't have to write or come up with ideas now. Let's go! So that Porsche commercial was a Fast and Furious parody, making it our first cinematic category. You're gonna notice as time goes on that I get increasingly frustrated with the car commercials. I don't know what it is with car manufacturers specifically, but these ads are just way too serious for no reason. From ho-hum to so young. That made me want to quit this video like right now. So a Pop-Tarts ad featuring Jonathan Van Ness easily goes in famous people, because that commercial is literally just Jonathan Van Ness being Jonathan Van Ness. You can find it, you can do it. Dancing. There's going to be a lot of dancing. In fact, that was a TurboTax commercial, so if anyone wants to explain what that has to do with the dance party, I'm all ears.
I don't know where we parked, I was following you.
Now, I don't know where to put this Bill Murray ad for Jeep because it was half and half. I could easily put it under cinematic because it's a parody of Groundhog Day. However, it's also Bill Murray, so I could put it under famous people. I think I'm going to go with cinematic, though. Are you starting to notice how all of these advertisements are just bizarrely similar?
Target has been acquired. Get water! Get
water! This changes everything.
It's a water commercial. I think I'm going to put it on cinematic because they kind of made it look like The Martian. Then again, it also had Bill Nye there randomly saying two words. You know what? I'm going to stick with cinematic because trust me, there's going to be a lot more famous people ads. Like this next one.
You can't touch this.
All right, so I'm going to cut that off before I get copyright claimed. Here we have MC Hammer randomly showing up in a Cheetos ad because Cheetos get your fingers dirty and then you can't touch things. And MC Hammer's signature song is Can't Touch This. Honestly, I feel like they should just let me write these advertisements because if you want to not try, I'm pretty good at that, okay? You could be paying me Super Bowl commercial salaries.
Oh, you know when you should do that? Later.
Oh, later.
Yeah.
Well, when is later?
Now, the issue with Tide is that there were like three or four different Tide commercials. They invested their Super Bowl budget in like this MCU of Tide commercials. It was really annoying, but they primarily marketed it as a cinematic thing.
This just in, is Jonah Hill going to flake out on Martin Scorsese? The world wants to know.
The only thing the world wants to know is why Jonah Hill and Martin Scorsese would be in the same room together for any reason other than a Coca-Cola advertisement. So obviously that's going to go under famous people. Dancing. Now, I do appreciate that that commercial had Missy Elliott because anything involving Missy Elliott is going to be amazing. But honestly, dancing to a Pepsi commercial is really the last place I wanted to see her.
Engage the glutes. Yes.
We should go.
Jimmy Fallon and John Cena exercising together in a public gym. You know, celebrities are just like us. They definitely don't have private trainers. Anyway, this was a Michelob commercial. I think I said that right. And that, of course, goes under famous people.
Head in the sand?
That's offensive, Trish.
Yeah, Trish.
You from another planet?
I honestly couldn't tell if this was supposed to be like a Men in Black parody or if it was just supposed to be weird. I'm serious, I really needed to make a nightmare fuel category, but since I don't have one, I'm just gonna put it under cinematic. Also, this commercial was for something called Reese's 5-in-1, and the whole premise of the commercial was that nobody in that commercial had heard of it, which honestly, same. Literally, what is a Reese's 5-in-1 bar? I barely trust Reese's to get peanut butter and chocolate right. I'm not gonna go ahead and add three other things into the mix.
Today, Olay launches its very first space mission.
Who has the keys?
Wow, Lily Singh in an unfunny comedy sketch. I didn't expect to see that at the Super Bowl. No, really, I didn't expect to see Lily Singh at the Super Bowl. I'm actually kind of impressed at how far she goes in her career, despite me not knowing anybody in my life who finds her funny. But that Olay ad, of course, goes under famous people.
Guys, we're incredibly rich. Let's get both.
I'll get both.
Post Malone buying beer from a convenience store. You know, I think that's the reason I don't like these famous people ads. This is not how rich people act. It's like they even acknowledge in this ad, guys, we're super rich, but like, you're still at a convenience store. Post Malone ordered over $40,000 worth of Postmates in a year. He is not leaving his house for food. But nevertheless, this Bud Light commercial goes under famous people. Dancing. Though I have to say, Sam Elliott outdanced Lil Nas X, which I did not see coming. Nevertheless, hearing the song Old Town Road in a Doritos advertisement played during the Super Bowl felt like a fever dream that I am incapable of waking up from.
Show me photos of me and Loretta.
Bro, it's a Google ad. It is not that serious. This goes under emotional. I can't decide which one of these categories I like less, but I'm leaning towards emotional because all this drama and music when it's from like these unethical companies trying to pretend like they're human. The only thing that these companies hold dear to their heart is their bottom line.
That's the best thing since sliced bread.
We got a problem.
There's a new best thing.
Rainn Wilson from The Office. This Little Caesars ad obviously goes under famous people. By the way, the whole premise of that ad is just gratingly unfunny. Sliced bread headquarters because it's the best thing since sliced bread. It's like so many of these commercials hinge on very thinly working puns. I did not expect that to be a theme of the Super Bowl 2020 commercials, but unfortunately it was.
What is happening?
What is that? Is that a baby nut?
So after all this controversy, after my whole video about planters, the best thing they could come up with after that train wreck of a Super Bowl ad was baby nut. That's the worst thing I've heard in my entire life. I'm gonna put that under emotional though, for them trying to pander to that same crowd that thinks Baby Yoda is the best thing since sliced bread. No Little Caesars reference intended. Here we have Heinz going way too hard because it's literally just ketchup. Gonna put this in the cinematic section. I guess the theme of this commercial was like, everyone uses ketchup, which maybe I would be more sympathetic to if I did use it, but I hate ketchup.
It's that I'm a cancer survivor, had a tumor on my heart, and only a 1% chance of survival.
Holy crap, this emotional manipulation. Was like, what's more heart-wrenching than like a sad dog? A sad dog with cancer who almost didn't make it. If this WeatherTech commercial doesn't go under emotional, I don't know what does. You're gonna fix the world by feeding it hyper-concentrated sugar. I would feel better about this advertisement if Snickers actually were fun to eat. They are so sticky and get stuck to the back of your teeth. You know, feeding the world Snickers might actually accomplish world peace because no one would be able to speak. Gonna put that under emotional for that little kumbaya moment they tried to have.
If you looked at America like a bird and that was all you knew.
America, families, wide sweeping shots of rural area. It's like, we get it. Gonna go ahead and put this Walmart ad under emotional. I don't appreciate a company as gross as Walmart trying to pretend like they're for people. Imagine using the word family at all when you typically don't pay the average worker there enough to even support a family. No, I thought I was... No! I don't know what that Dashlane commercial was, but obviously that goes under cinematic.
We live typical American lives. Like this typical American, showing off his strength.
Oh my gosh, we get it. I'm in America. Maybe I'm just not patriotic enough to understand these ads, but using the word America does not make me more likely to purchase something. Nevertheless, Budweiser still came through with that emotional approach. By the way, how in the world have I already done half of these, and none of them have been outside the four categories?
How much do you think Pringles paid these people?
Hardly anything.
I work really hard to not watch Rick and Morty. I don't know who asked for them to be in a Pringles commercial, but there they were, and now I've consumed Rick and Morty content. I feel like I should be able to sue.
How about Dorchester?
Packed it. Foxborough? Packed it.
The Garden?
Packed it.
Saugus?
Packed it.
Swampscott?
Revere?
The Harbor?
Are you kidding me? I packed it and then unpacked it.
You unpacked it?
Wow, Chris Evans using a Boston accent is the whole premise of this commercial. This goes under famous people. Maybe it would have been better if that was like at least a decent Boston accent. But hey, I guess you get what you get. At least he was showing more emotion than his entire performance in the Marvel Cinematic Universe.
John! Where were you? It was supposed to be a thing and you made it not a thing.
I think we all want to roll the window up on Chrissy Teigen. This Genesis commercial obviously goes under famous people.
It's got pictures on it.
I like pictures.
Yeah, me too. That's why I'm making it.
It's Winona Ryder sitting outside of Winona, the place. So, by Squarespace, apparently. Obviously goes under famous people. And I think this is like the third or fourth pun that we've encountered so far. I'm sorry. Did Hummer just say zero emissions? When I think pollution and carbon footprint, I literally think Hummer. I guess they realized that single-handedly destroying the atmosphere wasn't a good look for them. So now in 2020, we get a more eco-friendly Hummer. It's literally like setting something on fire and then saying, oh, I'll put it out.
Hey, mama, what's up?
Did you switch my service from Verizon to T-Mobile?
Anthony Anderson and his mom. You're right, I should switch from Verizon to T-Mobile. As if Anthony Anderson is the one managing his mom's cell phone service. If I was that rich, I would pay someone to help my mom with her technology problems. Okay, I do have to give Amazon props for these visual effects. This advertisement goes under cinematic. However, they also threw Ellen DeGeneres in the beginning randomly, so I could just as easily put it under famous people. It's like, you know what? If the Game of Thrones aspect doesn't work, we could just go the late night television route. Actually, is she late night or daytime? I don't even own a television.
Josh, it's gonna be hard growing up homeless. But you gotta believe in yourself.
Bro, this is literally a Kia ad. Hey, you know what's really gonna sell cars this year? Homelessness. Just, that's all I got. That goes under emotional. There are actually way more of these emotional ads than I thought. I feel like at this point in time, people look past this stuff. You know, I think it takes more than waving around a dog or a sad story or some loud piano music to get someone to buy your product. But if that's working well enough to get them to the Super Bowl, I need to get a dog because I have merch coming out.
Here's Mountain Dew Zero.
I am thirsty.
Here we got a classic movie reference. That ad was almost good, but it was wasted on Mountain Dew. I don't know if you've ever had Mountain Dew, but it tastes pretty much the way it looks.
I hope this doesn't give me helmet hair.
I don't know who they were supposed to be, but I'm assuming they were famous, so I'm just gonna put that under famous people.
Critter's got an ugly mouth.
That's not its mouth.
Oh, I just had this washed.
Another car commercial. I'm looking at the ones I have left, and I have yet another car commercial coming up.
Above normal.
Oh, heck no, lady. You're not about to get me copyright claimed. She literally sings Let It Go just in the middle of traffic. If that is not supposed to be an emotional ploy, I do not know what is. The only emotion traffic makes me feel is regret, I think, for leaving my house. Is that an emotion? And here we have the last advertisement for avocados from Mexico.
Remember, your avocado is worth it. Shop now. We'll throw in Molly. Wait.
Shop now and we'll throw in Molly. They said that on national television. So this goes under famous people because I could have sworn I've seen that lady somewhere, but I'm just not remembering where she's from at this time. All right, so we have three under dancing. I guess that was fewer dancing ones than I thought. Then again, three is altogether too many. 10 ads under cinematic because when in doubt, just increase your budget. 10 ads under emotional because home is where the heart is and the heart is the fastest path to the wallet. And then we have 16 under famous people because that one's pretty self-explanatory. So altogether, I think that's about 40 Super Bowl ads and not one ounce of originality. I just saved you 4 hours, trust me. I think the reason it makes me sad is because as a kid, I would just be so into watching the Super Bowl for the commercials. But now I'm starting to wonder, was I just bad at discerning good media? Like, maybe Super Bowl commercials have always been bad and I just didn't know it. But you know what? I'm sure these companies' bottom line probably doubled overnight, so ultimately, who cares?